going to show you how to enter the date invoiced and the date due. I will show you the code first. So we have the order number here, and then we have the amount that they were charged, and then we have the PO number, and then we have an X beside it if it's ready to be invoiced. So now I'll show you what the code looks like. So first of all, define some variables here. Dim equals range, X equals long, and that's in the number of the line. PO order number equals a string, and that's obviously the PO number on our sheet, and row as long. And so we start with the second row because the first row has headings, so X equals 2. Okay, so now I'm saying do while sheets cell 1, which is the order number, has something in it. And if sheets 1 cells equals 1 has something in it, or sheets 1 cells X9, this is where we put the X, does not have an X, then what you do is you go, you increase 1. So now your row would be the row plus 1. And then you go to end O, and end O is just before the loop so that it will continue to loop after it's gone if things don't go that way. Now, I define the PO number as in the sheet 1 cells X 8 column dot value, so that's the PO number. And then we define the end row equals sheets 2, rows count 1, and sheets up plus 1 row. Now we copy from to sheets 2, we copy the PO number, and then we copy the value that was, and then we want to put in, when we put this in the invoiced sheet. So what we're doing is sheets 2, column 3, and the value equals date. Now, what we have to do, unless we want a serial number for our date, we define that the number format equals month, day, year. And then we want to know when this invoice is due. So what we're going to do is we are going to go sheets 2, end row 4 equals value equals, what we're doing is we're adding 30 days to the value that we have in the third column. And then we're going to format that again. Now what we're going to do is, if we've done this sheet cell, we're going to select the one that has the X in it. And then we're going to delete the whole row, because it doesn't need to be on the PO sheet once it's been invoiced. And then we loop. So now let's run this code. So I have this one here with the X beside it and a PO number in it. So I'm going to macros, I'm going to invoice C, and now I'm gonna run this. I go to macros, I go to invoice C, and I run this. And now when I go to sheet 2, there you have the information copied over here with the date that was invoiced, which is today, the date that it's due, which is 30 days from now. And then if you go back here, the ones that have the X have now been deleted from this. So that's how you put, you enter the date invoiced and the date due when you're using VBA. Please subscribe.